Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have discussed about the ionic bond and in that case we have taken an example of the formation of the NaCl, that how NaCl bond is formed. But in actual practice there are various steps that are been taking place and because of which the NaCl is been formed. So now we are going to talk about basically a small example, that is a bond Haber cycle for the formation of NaCl. So let us talk about it and let us see that how the ionic bonds are been formed. So now we are going to discuss about the bond Haber cycle for the formation of NaCl, and that is the reason that because of it consists of a electropositive that is element or electropositive atom, that is sodium, and that of electronegative atom, that is chlorine atom, and they combine with each other so as to form NaCl. But there are various processes that takes place in this case, and so let us understand it. So while talking about the general reaction, we could say that sodium, which is of the solid phase, it will combine with that of the molecule of, that is chlorine, and so as to form basically NaCl. And this NaCl is the one that has been formed, and that is formed because of sodium has a positive charge while chlorine has a negative charge. But meanwhile, in this case, amount of energy is also been that is liberated, and that is the reason that we could say that the delta H formation, or the heat released during the formation of NaCl, that is what we have written over here, and that is it was been found to be -381.8 kJ. So this much amount of energy is being released when sodium combines with that of the chlorine gas, but this doesn't take place directly. We have to give a following steps that are involved in the formation of NaCl, and let's start with it. So talking about the first step, so the first step, that is what we do, is we convert the sodium atom into its ion, and that is what it is known as sublimation. So we are doing the sublimation process where the solid phase of sodium has been converted into the gaseous phase. So now the first thing that we could write it over here as sublimation of sodium. So in this process, basically what happens is, that is sodium, which is present in a solid phase, it has been converted into that is Na, which is basically a gaseous phase. So therefore this will be converted into, that is the process is known as sublimation, so we would write it over here, and that solid phase has been converted into, that is gaseous phase, and the amount of heat that has been required, and that is basically we could write it because it, we are doing the sublimation process, so therefore delta H of having a subset S, that indicates that is the sublimation process that has been taken place, and that is the reason that plus 108.5 kJ of energy has been required so as to convert the sodium, which is of solid phase, to the gaseous phase. And this is the first step that we have did. And talking about the next one that we can do, yes, we can do, that is the second step is what we are going to mention about, and that is basically, so this is the thing that we have did for that is sodium, but meanwhile we can also discuss it for chlorine. And the chlorine atom, that is what we need, because Na will combine with that of Cl so as to form NaCl. So but the chlorine gas is been that is it is in the form of, that is gaseous phase, so that is what we have to do, that is we have to dissociate it. So if we dissociate, then only it will be converted into, that is chlorine atom. So in this process, that is in step number 2, we'll dissociate it. So I will write it over here, that is we are going, that is this is the one that is undergoing dissociation so as to form, that is Cl, which is of gaseous phase. So this step 2 is what we have, and that is the amount of heat that has been required so as to for the dissociation is basically, it is found to be, that is 121.5 kJ. And the second step is basically known as dissociation of Cl2. So this is what we have, or we could say dissociation, or we could say that is atomization. So in that case, the both are same, and this is what we have got over here. But the thing is, we have to, again, this sodium and this chlorine, they won't react it directly because they are in their atomic form and not in the ionic form, and we know that they form the ionic bond And so the first thing that we have to do is we have to convert them into ions, and in that case also the amount of energy would be required so as to convert them into ions. So the first thing is we will convert sodium into its ion, and we'll convert that is Cl, that is chlorine atom, into its ion, and then we will combine it. So the third step is basically ionization of that is sodium. So what happens in this process is basically sodium, which is of a gaseous phase, is been converted into basically Na plus by liberating one electron. So now this is the one that has been formed, that is sodium ion has been formed, and this is of gaseous phase. So in this case the energy always it is needed, and that is nothing but the we could say like ionization enthalpy. So that has been needed so as to remove the electron. So we could also name it as ionization enthalpy of that particular sodium, or we could say like delta H of here I have written it as ion. So the amount of energy that has been required so as to remove this electron, and it has been found to be that is 495.2 kilojoule of energy has been required so as to remove the electron, and this is what we have. And the second thing that we have to do is, yes, we have to convert the chlorine atom into a chloride ion, and that is what we are going to discuss about, and that is step number 4. And that is again we could say ionization of that is chlorine atom. And in this case basically the chlorine will have to accept the electron, because chlorine is the one which is more electronegative, so it has the tendency to gain electrons, unlike sodium which has the tendency to give electrons. So in this case basically I would write it in this way, that is chlorine, which is of a gaseous phase, it will have to accept an electron, and then only it will convert into Cl minus ion, and that is also of a gaseous phase. But meanwhile it is not giving its electron, so we are not ionizing in term of by removing electron, but in terms of gaining electrons. So that is the reason that we could name it as electron gain enthalpy. So we could write it as EG, electron gain enthalpy, or electron affinity. That's the tendency of the chlorine to accept, and that is how in this case the energy is not been it don't need an energy so as to convert the Cl into Cl minus, but it releases the energy, and that is what we could see, that the electron gain enthalpy has a minus sign, and that is having that is 348.3 kilojoule of energy is being released when an electron is combined with that of a chlorine atom, and this is what we have. So if you observe that our main motive has been done, that is we have got the Na plus and that is Cl minus. So the thing is very clear, that is we could see that Na will combine with that of Cl so as to form NaCl. So let us do the fifth step. And the fifth step is, I would write it over here as that is formation of NaCl. And that is how it forms, that is Na plus, that is what we have obtained, along with that of the Cl minus, that is what we have obtained during the process, and this is how the NaCl has been formed because of the electrostatic force of attraction. And obviously the energy would be released, and that kind of energy is basically denoted by delta H, and this delta H gives the lattice energy of the we could say the overall NaCl molecule between the NaCl molecules. So the amount of energy that has been needed so as to form that is NaCl, so that is what the lattice energy is. So this is what we have got over here, and let us see that what we have discussed in this overall formation of NaCl. So just a small glimpse of it, that is what we have did is the sodium, which was present in a solid phase, along with that we have combined with the half moles of that is Cl2 gas so as to obtain that is NaCl. Along with that obviously some amount of heat has been liberated during this formation, and that is basically delta H. But in this case basically what we have did is we have converted the sodium, which is of solid phase, into that is sodium, which is of the gaseous phase, and that is what here the energy that was being spent, it was the sublimation process. So I would write it over here as sublimation. and meanwhile we have converted the chlorine molecule to its ion or to its atom. So that is what the atomization process has taken place over here, or we could call it as dissociation. So we would named it as dissociation. So now in this case we see the chlorine has been turned into molecule, that molecule has been turned into an atom. So now the rest of the thing is we have converted this sodium into, that is, Na plus, and in this case basically the energy required to remove the electron, and that is ionization, that what we have did by removal of electron. And meanwhile the chlorine gas was again converted into basically an ion, but in this case it has gained electron, so I would name it as electron gain enthalpy, and that is what we have got over here. So now this, the both two of which they have combined, that is, so as to form, that is, NaCl. So this overall energy that has been required so as to form Na and Cl, that was, that is, lattice energy, and that has been denoted by, I suppose, capital L. So in this case basically what we have got to know, that various kind of energy that has been required so as to give a particular amount of heat, and that is what we could say, that is the delta HF, or the heat of formation of NaCl, is basically the combination of the various energies that were being involved in this case. And we could write that the energy that were being involved, it was basically sublimation. So we will write it over here as delta H of sublimation, along with that of delta H of dissociation, along with that of, we could say, that is delta H of ionization, along with that of the delta H of electron gain enthalpy or electron affinity, and ultimately that is what we have got, a lattice energy, and that is, we could name it as this one. So therefore we could say that the overall lattice energy is what we could say, that it can be easily calculated, and that is basically if we combine the HF along with that of the whole thing will be on one side, and this one would be basically delta HS along with that of delta HD plus delta H ion and delta H of EG. So basically we are doing a thermodynamic term, and so as to understand that what is the lattice energy between the sodium and the Cl. And so suppose if that is what we don't know, but even we can calculate that one. So the delta H of was, it was been found to be that of that is minus 381.8, along with that of the delta S of or we could say delta H of sublimation, it was been found to be that of that is 108.5, and if we combine with that of the dissociation cons or dissociation, the energy required to dissociate it, so therefore it was found to be 121.5, and that of the ionization, it was basically 495.2, and the electron gain enthalpy, and it was found to be basically that is of minus 348.3 kilojoule. So if you combine this thing, then let us see that is what is the answer that we could get. So we have got that is minus 758.7 kilojoule. So this is the lattice energy of between sodium ion and chlorine chloride ion, and that is what we have understood it. And so this is the thing that has been formed, that is NaCl has been formed, not only by sharing the electrons but overall in this process. So that was a short thermodynamic term that we have did over here, and that's it. This is what I want to talk about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and we have did it, and share this video to friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.